We are here. We are here. We are
here. 이거 진짜 멋있다.
As you're walking into the tunnel, you're surrounded by the voices of hundreds of New Yorkers who have participated in the piece.
You only get one shot. Do not miss a chance to go.
We have a little intercom, like a microphone, that records your voice.
Sandra stole my heart.
It is better to light a candle than curse the darkness.
And then converts your voice to light.
How much is the toll for this tunnel?
And then every time that a new person records a voice, all the previous recordings get moved down one position toward the outside of the tunnel. It's 150 channels of sound that are telling you stories, but then it also has the 300 spotlights, which in a way visualize the voice itself.
Now that strength, which in old days moves heaven and earth, that which we are, we are.
Here is a chance, it's an open mic, to have your voice converse with others. One of the things that we are seeing, and I'm very happy about that, is that people are also listening and replying back to what people said in the past. Perhaps the most symbolic one was a fellow who actually proposed marriage to his fiance or to his girlfriend, and she replied yes, and then their voices traveled together down the tunnel as more people participate, and they walked throughout the tunnel.
Until our hope is met in heaven.
In the case of freedom of speech, after Snowden, after PRISM, there are just so many different systems that are constantly tracking us. I think it's really important for artists to intervene in that, to actually, instead of create suspicion and surveillance and Orwellian situations, you're creating environments that are poetic or connective or critical, that create community, that brings us closer together. My feeling, and I know it's idealistic and utopian, is that art is helping society create these cohesive bonds that ultimately make us safer.